Welcome to day 11 of competition here at the 2017 Summer Universiade. Up first, we will head to the Taipei Tianmu Baseball Stadium in Taipei City for the men's bronze medal game between Czech Republic and the Republic of Korea. Bottom of the first, man on third, a big hit by Lee Kukbill, gets by the infielders, and he hits in number 9, Cho Tae-seung, for the first run of the game. Korea now leads 1-0. Connects right with the end of the bat, zips by the third baseman there with a weird little bounce, and he gets it in. We're in the fifth now. Czech Republic able to catch up 1-1, and a nice hit by Kukbill gets on first. Now Choi Hyung Sun up to bat. Sets up for the sacrificial bunt, pulls it back, and Kukbill steals second, and he's safe. One strike, man on second. Choi Kong Mo puts it right over the second baseman, and Kukbill heads home. And just like that, it's 2-0 for the Republic of Korea. The right fielder gets it home, but Kukbill slides on the outside of the catcher, touching home with his hand, and he's easily safe. Watch as he rounds third. Goes nice and wide, avoids the catcher, touches that bottom corner of the plate, and it's good. Now, top of the sixth, two out, man on second. A big hit by Thomas Junek goes right over into the outfield in between right and center. And Arnas Dubavy lights a rocket behind him, goes from second to home and scores. Ties it up now for the Czech Republic, 2-2. Fast forward two more innings now. Bottom of the eighth, 3-2 Korea. Two men on base, one and third. Lee Ho Young dings one, hits the sweet spot on that back check, struggles to get it in, and that one is going to score both. Lee ends up on third. Watch how close this one got to the foul line here. Right on the line, the hardest place to throw that in when he gets to the third base. Scoring two now, they lead the way, 6-2. Top of the ninth, two out, one on first. A full count, and Michael Zima's gotta hit it. He grounds it to the third baseman, and it's an easy out on first, and that's gonna end the game. Republic of Korea wins the bronze medal over Czech Republic with a final score of 6-2. Let's go inside now to the crowded Taipei Arena that would host the bronze medal matchup today in men's basketball between Team Serbia and Team Latvia. Serbia would get the possession off the jump. Throughout this bronze medal game, each team would have a double-digit lead. The lead would change 5 times and was tied at least 3 times. Nanadic passes it in to Brick. Brick, the big man underneath, swooshes it in for the first lead. Now Serbia up 12-7 to Latvia. Latvia's Birkins, 3 ball up top, nothing but net. It's now 12-10. But on the other end, it was Serbia's Dukovic who put the answer in for 3 to take the lead 15-10. And at the end of the first quarter, it was Serbia 20, Latvia 14. Latvia looking to get back in it. Plavnik's 3 is good, brings them back up now within 6. On the other end now, 33-24. As the time winds down, 10 seconds, Dukovic drives off the left-hand side glass, is good, but Latvia's number 3, Berkans, goes back, and that one is good at the buzzer. And at the end of the half, it's Serbia 35, Latvia 26. Midway through the third, Berkans comes up strong again, the jumper from the corner is good. Latvia takes the lead now for the first time, 45-43. Serbia ties it back up with a floater in the middle of the key by Pavlovic. On the other end, though, Plavnik has something to say about it. Up top now, the switch. He's got a big man on him, goes to the basket, drives, a scoop off the glass is good. At the end of the third, it's Latvia 51, Serbia 48. Minute into the fourth, Lassenberg's in the corner, pump fake, drives by two defenders, finds the open man in the corner, and Berzins puts it in for 3 points to extend the lead. Now Latvia 62, Serbia 55. Serbia gets it into Tejic down low. He gets the and one to fall. The bucket and the foul with 4:37 left to go on the clock. Fast forward 2 minutes now. Stuck underneath. He gets it out to Plavnik's. Extra pass to Johnsens. Knocks it down from up top. Latvia would stay on the offensive now. Here's Plavnik's up top. Pushes forward, right hand floater is good. Now 74-64, the 10-point lead. Serbia comes back into it, 78-71, and a last chance shot by Djokovic. Gets them up even more, brings them to 74, but it wouldn't be enough for Latvia's 81. And as the time winds down, they throw the ball in the air and celebrate. Latvia has won the bronze medal at this year's Summer Universiade. Plavnik and Johnsens each added 19 points to Serbia's total. Berzins added 18, including shooting 3 from 6 from beyond the arc. We've traveled over to Fujian Catholic University Stadium for the men's bronze medal football match between Team Mexico and Team Uruguay. Uruguay on the right side of your screen in the blue, Mexico on the left in the green. Before the game, Miguel Maldonado was presented with a special World Fair Play diploma. This game would come down to the wire, so almost 7.5 minutes in, both teams still scoreless. Uruguay's Christofferson puts it in and needs a little help by Juan Dupuy, but still will not hit the back of the net. Then at the 10-minute mark, it's Jose Cruz Armenta that gets past a couple defenders, gets it over to Vallecas, and off the post. That one is as close as any shot gets this first half. We move on now to additional minutes in the first. Bala Martinez Castro gets by a few defenders, sets up Leon for a wide open shot in front of the net. He just can't put it in. It goes right to the right side of the net, and at the half, it's still 0-0. 56.5 minutes into the second, and Mexico gets another shot on net, this time just a bit high. It goes back into the bleachers. End of regular time, we're into the added time now. Mexico's Martinez tries to get around the defender. A nice little move there. Up in the air, they get a shot off, a great defense there by Uruguay. Uruguay now in possession. It looks like everyone on the field touched the ball in that one, and that's gonna end the time. This one went into penalty shots. We'll skip ahead now to the 7th penalty shot. The first 6 all got past the goalkeeper, so now it is 3-3 as Mexico's Kevin Quinones gets up, and that one with a little dizzle and fake to the side is in. They take the lead now 4-3. Next up was Uruguay's Guillermo Guerrera Lena. Shoots it in, and the goalkeeper, Jesus Galindo, does not fall for it. He's able to stop it, and that's the first save in this penalty shootout. So now it's all up to Mexico's Patricio Trevino. If this one is in, they win the game, and it's the same move as before. They fake to one side and kick it in the other. Mexico wins the bronze medal over Uruguay, 5-3 in the penalty shootout. Mexico, who came in 11th at the last Universiade, is going home with gold this year. Let's head inside to Nanyang Exhibition Center for the Rhythmic Gymnastics Individual Finals.
Execution reference one.
First up, we will watch the gold medal performance in the hoop event. This was performed by Russia's Yulia Bravinkova. She would leave this Universiade with 5 medals to her name, including the gold medal in this hoop event. For this performance, the judges award her a difficulty score of 9.6, an execution score of 8.85, for a total of 18.45. She took the gold medal over her teammate, Yekaterina Selezneva.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Selezneva also won a gold medal of her own in this performance with the individual ball final. She would end with a total of 17 points. She also won the silver in all-around hoop and ribbon, and she earned the bronze medal in the clubs event. В нем приснился долгий поцелуй. Мы гуляли там по облакам. Я узнаю утро. Ты узнаешь позже. Вечно в дороге. Без таких вот звоночков я же зверь одиночка. Промахнусь и хнусь ночью незаметно. Selezneva inches out Bravinkova for the gold medal, and it was Bravinkova that took the silver. Next up is the Group 5 Hoops event. Russia absolutely dominated the finals here with rhythmic gymnastics, and that wouldn't change for this group event. The judges awarded this performance a difficulty score of 9.5, which was only second highest in the group, but it was their execution score of 8.025 that brought them the total of 17.525 and won them the gold medal. Next up is the individual clubs final. Again, we will watch Russia's Yulia Bravinkova compete in this one and absolutely dominate in these events today. She is a 2014 European Junior Hoop Champion and a two-time 2013 and 2014 Russian Junior National All-Around Champion. An absolutely beautiful performer. Bravinkova earned 17.9 on that final club's performance. The second place earner, 16.525. Next up is the ribbons final, and once again, we will watch Russia's Bravinkova perform.
Let's go! Oh, dancing! Now everybody move!
Bravikova takes this one easily with a score of 16.550. Her Russian teammate scoring 14.95 and earning the silver medal. Next up, three balls, two ropes, team final. Russia once again showing their dominance in the rhythmic gymnastics event. Russia wins gold, Chinese Taipei wins the silver, and the Ukraine wins the bronze as Russian teammate Bravikova cheers on the sideline. She won five medals today, including gold in all-around hoop, clubs, and ribbon, and a silver medal in the ball. What a showing for the Russian gymnast here today. We'll move over to the Taiwan University Sports Center for another bronze medal matchup, this time in men's volleyball. It will feature Japan taking on the Ukraine. A spike by Imamuro starts it off hot for Japan. They take the first lead of the game and they keep it. 18-14 here, a spike by Nevia Domsky gets them back into it, 18-15 now. Now at set point, it's an out-of-bounds serve by Shapova, who ends the game now. First game goes to Japan. In the second now, the Ukraine's Vladenko gets the spike, it's dug, and then Nevia Domsky spikes again, and it is blocked. That one goes right back in bounds, point Japan. Shapova now gets a spike. That one, no one knows who it is, but it is tipped out of bounds off of Japan. That point will go to the Ukraine. Now here at set point, it's another service error at the most important point of the game. Now it's tied up 1-1. A spike here by Draws is in, and they get the point now, bringing them within one to Japan. Japan, though, takes the lead now 17-15. A beautiful serve there by Kiselek. Now the spike by Shevchenko. Puts it down, great rally here. Imamura for Japan looks to end it though with a huge spike as he falls to the ground. They take the lead 18-15. Now at set point, Japan leads the way. Fukuyama puts the spike down and it's a powerful one. Now Japan up 2-1. Ukraine now do or die here. They're down by one versus Japan. Kasilyak puts the spike up. It's blocked and it falls on the side of Japan. It's all tied up. Moving forward though, 24-21, match point. Almost a service error there, but it goes over. Beautiful spike, beautiful dig. The Ukraine looking to stay alive. Imamura tries to end it here with a spike, but it's dug up once again, returned to the Japanese side quickly. Hisahara goes for it. The small tip will end the entire game. Lack of coverage for the Ukraine. And it's Japan who wins the bronze medal in the men's volleyball event here at the 29th Summer Universiad. Now it's time for the men's and women's singles table tennis finals. The women's final between Korea and Chinese Taipei took to the table first. For Korea, it was Jung Ji-hee, and for Taipei, Cheng Yi-ching. In game one, Taipei's Cheng took the early lead, 10-5. Here's match point for the hometown athlete, and she gets it. She goes up 1-0. Second game is taken by the Korean athlete, and she'll stay on top in this game too. Right now, 8-5. She finishes with a total of 12-10. Next was game four. A great rally by the two athletes. Eventually, the Taipei athlete would go on to win it 11-7. In game five, the Korean athlete comes back, winning it 11-9, and here's game six. Match point now for Jiang Ji-hee. If she scores this one, she will win the gold medal. That one a bit too long, and the Korean athlete will take the gold medal in the women's table tennis singles final. Jiang Ji-hee, the gold medal, and for Taipei, it's Cheng Yi-ching with the silver. Next up is the men's singles final. Representing Japan is Masataka Morozono, and for the Chinese Taipei, it's Chen Qian'en. Japan's Morozono went on to take the early lead in the first game, 9-1, but it was Taipei's Chen that battled back into it, now 10-6 for Morozono. A little bit too strong there for Chen, and it's Morozono that takes the first lead. Now in game two, it's Chen leading the way 10-6. He won that eventually 11-6. In game three, Japan up 9-6 right now. A monster slam there by Morozono. He goes on to win that game 11-7. He won game four as well, and now we're watching game five. Japan leading 6-3. Great defense by Chen. He's able to get it cross court to the other end, and it's good for one more point. Now, Japan leading 8-5. A beautiful shot by Morozono. He's up now 10-8. Match point now for these two athletes. A shot into the net will end it for Chen. Masataka Morozono wins the gold medal in the men's singles table tennis final. It was Morozono that won the first game 11-6. Chen battled back to win 11-6 himself in the second, but then 3-4 and 5 are won by Morozono. From table tennis over to Taipei Tennis Center for the women's singles tennis final between Chinese Taipei's Li Ya Shen and Thailand's Vera Thatcher Wong Tin Chai. In the first set, Thailand went up 2-1, and in the fourth, she's up 40-30 over Taipei. A short return results in a point for Thailand, but Taipei battles back to tie it up. Then, at the tiebreak set point, Taipei hits it out, and Thailand takes the first set. She's up now 1-0. Second set, 10th game advantage Taipei. This set lasted a grueling 81 minutes. Thailand goes for the kill, and Taipei places that return perfectly and wins the second set. She ties it up now, one set apiece. In the third set, 7th game, Thailand leads 40-30 over Taipei. At the gold medal point, Taipei serves a stinger down the middle. Thailand returns it with ease. And when Taipei tries to go deep, it lands out and gives Thailand the point. She wins this game 6-1 to take the match 2-1 over Taipei. These two athletes faced up earlier in the games during the women's team classification and went right back at it today in the finals. Li Yashin's second medal here at the Universiade after winning the gold in the women's team classification. And for Wong Tin Chai, adding to her medal collection today as she earned the silver in both women's team classification and women's doubles. Now the men's singles finals got underway between Taipei's Jason Jiang and Korea's Hyung Jiang Chen. In the first set, third game, 40-30 for Taipei's Jiang, and he zings one down the line. The crowd goes wild and he goes up 5-2. Now at set point, 40-30, Taipei over Korea. Oh. A long one by Hung gives Taipei's Jason Jung the point. Now he goes up one set to nothing. In the second set, 5-3 right now, Taipei leading over Korea. And with the points, it's 30-15. Taipei looking to return, puts it in the net and gives Korea one more game. Now 5-4, Taipei leading 40 love. This is the gold medal point here. Korea needs to keep it in to stay alive and just can't return it after an absolute smash by Taipei's Jason Jung. This is Jung's second gold medal here at the Universiade, and he does it in front of a sold-out hometown crowd. Finally, we will head to Taiwan Sport University Arena to watch the women's bronze medal water polo matchup. This one would take place between Russia and Japan. Russia would swim in the white caps, Japan in the blue. Russia started off hot, scoring early, but it was Japan's Suzuki that tied it up from a long bomb shot from the top. Then in the second quarter, Japan takes the lead, and it's Russia's number three that shoots from the outside, stopped by Aoki in net, but the rebound goes to Isakova, who scoops it in as they try and climb their way back into this game. Great stop there, an easy rebound though as it comes in, and Isakova shoots it from deep. Now with 30 seconds left to go in the second quarter, and the loud Russian cheers going. It's a beautiful ball movement, leads to a goal by Gorobunova. Check it out, she gets wide open there, and that one will end the first half. In the third now, 2 minutes left. Russia shows some patience until it's Gorobunova who puts it in from deep again. She sees the opening and strikes. Brings Russia now within one. Now a minute 30 left to go. Gorobunova does it back to back, and she ties it up 7-7. Russia quickly takes the lead now, and with 44 seconds left to go, Japan's number 12 ties it up once again. Now it's 8-8. In the fourth and final quarter now, 2 minutes left, 30 seconds on the shot clock. Trotskaya comes up from underwater, whips it in to tie it once again. Now 11-11. 1:26 on the clock. Japan's Armira squeaks it in on the left-hand side. They take the lead now 12-11. A beautiful shot by Armira. Now under 30 seconds left to go in the game. A shot by USA will look to tie it up, and the block will end it for Aoki. She's going to look to go coast to coast now, run down the clock. 5 seconds to go until the bronze medal is hers. You can see the smile on her face, and when that final buzzer goes, it's Japan that comes out on top to win the bronze medal over Russia. The final score, 12-11.